What's up, guys? James here with Fun Fact of the Day. Hope you guys are having a great day, learning lots, and getting stuff done. Today, I have probably the weirdest and grossest and most dark story that I have ever told on this channel, but it is an interesting one. Alright, so, imagine the year is 1518. You're in the Holy Roman Empire, and you walk out, you know, planning to go to work, and you see your neighbor just out in the street, dancing. No reason, no music. And she's been doing this for hours, her feet are bleeding. And then she keeps going until she collapses. And then a couple days later, some more people join her. And this keeps happening for a month. And because it's 1518, ecstasy hadn't even been invented yet. Yes, this sounds like the stuff of an urban legend, but it actually happened, and it is extremely well documented. So let's talk about it. It all started with some lady named Frau Trophia. She left the house one day and did exactly what I just talked about. She started dancing. No music, nothing. And then, when she was done dancing that night, she just collapsed on the ground. Nobody could wake her up, and then in the morning, she got up and she kept going. And she did this for almost a week. And during this time, the rest of the town's women decided, maybe I should join her. And so, by the end of the week, there were maybe 15 women doing the exact same thing. No food, no water, nothing. Eventually, the townspeople took the original lady to the Temple of Saint Vitus. And they did this because apparently this saint curses people with the dance fever, and they'll dance forever. So they all believed this, and they decided, alright, we need to cleanse this lady, and maybe everybody else will stop. But when they got back a few days later, dozens more people had continued dancing. It became a mob. So the townspeople decided they had to do something about it. Now, they looked usually back then to either the clergy or the doctors, and in this case, the clergy all said that obviously it was a curse. There was nothing they could do but cleanse them. But for some reason, they decided to go with the doctors on this one. Can't imagine why. Anyway, the doctors believed that they were all dancing because their blood was just too hot. They were hot-blooded. And the recommended procedure to fix all of these hot-blooded people at the time was bloodletting, which is essentially when they just drain a bunch of your blood, hoping that new, fresh, clean blood will grow back instead. However, for whatever reason, they decided that the actual cure for this dance fever was to just let them dance it out. They figured, alright, gyrate away. So, the town decided to bring in a whole bunch of food carts, and they built a stage, and they brought in dancers and instruments and all sorts of music and fun to keep them dancing for as long as they could, until, you know, the dance fever had worn off. Unfortunately for them, this turned out to be the worst decision they had ever made, ever. These people kept dancing, and more and more and more people kept joining them for weeks at a time. Yeah, that's right. This went on for an entire month, and people kept dying while dancing. They were literally dancing until they dropped. But they weren't just dropping from exhaustion, usually. It was usually things like heart attacks, strokes, infection from their bloody feet. It was disgusting. And at a certain point, over 15 people a day were reported to have died from dancing in this massive mob. And by the end of the month, over 400 deaths had occurred. And you thought raves were intense. These guys knew how to party. So, as bureaucrats usually do, the town city council took forever to decide that this was actually a bad idea. After they had hauled away 300 or 400 bodies, they thought, maybe dancing it out isn't the way to go. So they finally actually outlawed dancing, took down all of the random things that they had brought in for these people, like the food stands and the stages and the musicians, and then they gathered up all these people into carts and drove them on up to the Temple of Saint Vitus, because they decided to go with the clergy again. And it actually worked. After a while, they kind of calmed down and there was nothing more to it. That was it. So, now the question remains. Why in the world did all these people do this? Why did they literally dance until they dropped and died? I have no idea. But there are dozens of theories out there, and nobody is 100% sure. So let's cover all of them. The first one, which a few of you are probably thinking about right now, is a mold called ergot. Basically, it grows in damp rye, which is what they used to make bread out of. And this mold is known to have kind of hallucinogenic, psychogenic properties similar to LSD. So you'd think, all right, well, LSD is a rave drug, maybe they were all basically on LSD because of some bad bread. But unfortunately, doctors have already proven that that can't be the case because this particular mold causes extreme blood loss to the extremities. So it would be impossible to actually dance after eating it. So, if it's not the weird bread mold, what is it? Are they all just crazy? Well, yes. The current leading theory as to why this happened is that it was just a weird psychological problem that a bunch of people had all at the same time. You see, back in 1518, the plague had just been, you know, around killing everybody's families for about 200 years, and it was a rough time. Syphilis had also just rolled in, which made a bunch of people go crazy and killed them. And then it was the 1500s. Things weren't exactly nice. So there was a lot of stress on these people. And in times of extreme stress, there have been tons of reported instances of just mass hysteria and weird things. So what the current experts seem to think is the reason is that one lady started going crazy, and a bunch of other ladies kind of got in on it and thought, you know, I'm feeling kind of crazy. And then they get into a weird trance, and it just keeps going. And people have actually died from similar things like this, and there actually have been other dance fever incidents like this reported in similar time periods around that area. However, back in the day, they actually all believed that it was the curse of Saint Vitus, and that, you know, because they had all sinned, they were cursed, and so they were dancing. And that was the predominant theory written down by most historians of that time period, because that seemed to be the way things were. So if you like that weird story about dancing, click this link right here. I'll have another weird story about a dancing Michael Jackson video game where he fights off gangsters using dance moves. Subscribe if you haven't already. Like, it really helps me out. And I will see you soon.